happy to see you here. Unfortunately, I have to use this visual help because I'm a little bit jet lagged still. But we're very grateful to be here, and we want to say a huge thank you to WYES, and especially the precious help of Tim, Katie, and Peggy Laborde for this beautiful space and for bringing to life our vision for this evening. This is a special night for us. Tonight we not only pair two beautiful arts, and actually after seeing those beautiful cakes, three beautiful arts. Thank you so much to Katrina from Chepierre Bakery for doing this gorgeous work on, inspired by Suzanne's paintings. But we, Opus Opera, are also being paired with another beloved organization, Lyric Fest, who is thriving in Philadelphia and continues to do so in various places around the country. Tonight, we have the pleasure and we are lucky to have with us the two first ladies of Lyric Fest, Laura Ward. Her impeccable piano playing, whom many of you admired at our opening season wine event, and Suzanne DuPlantis. Who you all know as a beautiful mezzo-soprano from here, but who also has another artistic side in her, whom many of you probably didn't know. She's a wonderful painter, and we have the pleasure of enjoying some of her work here tonight. This only enhances the spirit and mission of Opus Opera, to bring arts closer to people, near and far, and for everyone to hopefully discover something new. Since our last season, we ourselves have discovered the beauties of art forms we were not familiar with, like circus arts, dancing, or even painting. Since we decided to make this evening happen, I myself got interested in painting, and I booked myself a course of watercolor painting and completely fell in love with the art. Isn't that wonderful? We want to thank each and every one of you for being here with us tonight and for supporting us with your generous contributions and your presence. We hope that every Opus Opera event lives up to your expectations and travels you even beyond them to places you haven't discovered yet. Enjoy the evening.
Ne fuis pas, New Orleans to sing for all of you. Laura and I are so touched that we are part of this festival, and we're coming, we sort of have done this in Philadelphia for about 16 years, and we're so proud of Opus Opera for blazing this territory here in New Orleans, and I know that you all will embrace it and enjoy the beautiful music that they have to offer. This next song is called Sirenia, Lilacs. Interesting enough, it's a flower that I have not painted. At first, when we were conceiving of all this, you know, I think Irini had decided that I would paint a painting for each of these songs, and I thought, oh no! But I will tell you a little story. The first time that I ever sang this song, it's by Rachmaninoff, was in Rachmaninoff Hall in Moscow, which was thrilling and scary at the same time. But it's a wonderful, simple song, one of Rachmaninoff's most simple songs, and it's about just the joy of walking out in the fresh morning and you know, seeing these beautiful bunches of lilacs. And the poet says, and there in the lilacs, that's where my poor happiness resides. And when I was traveling there, it was right at the time of Perestroika, and you know, when things were just being opened up, and it had been very, very difficult in Russia, and I thought to myself, wow, okay, I think I understand this song now, how much simple joy can be taken from those beautiful flowers. So, sirenia.
Oh, I heard in San Francisco when I was a student, I think I was 23 years old, Barbara Bonney sang it. And when she sang this song, just tears started streaming down my face. I was so moved. And I had this sense at that time, 20 plus years, to know, don't sing this song yet. Don't touch it. Not because I couldn't sing it vocally, because I didn't have the emotional depth to sing this song. I hadn't, please read the translations, I hadn't experienced that love.
No.
So tonight I'm going to dedicate this to my sweet husband, because now I can sing the song. No. One more sip of water.
Children, they're there for marriages and all of those occasions. And in this song, after one of the two lovers has passed away, probably the one who's remaining has put the flowers out and said, I'm going to put these flowers out like I once did in May, and I want to secretly hold your hand as I once did in May, and let us speak again of love as we once did in May. One day a year, Alla Seelen, All Souls Day, one day a year, are the dead alive. Come to me that I may speak to your heart again as once in May.
Anxiousness of a lotus blossom waiting for the night where she can actually shine and grow in love and in the love's pain, and we can all relate to that in, you know, waiting for the one that will make us feel this way, that we can shine and grow next to them.
Thank you.
was also a very, very prolific composer, and her work, especially her songs, aren't done that often. We thought it was really cool. He wrote Die Lotus Blume. She wrote Die Stille Lotus Blume, which I'm going to sing. I think, you know, another kind of fun note about this song is we all know the saying, a swan song. It's his swan song. Well, in German folklore, in this song, it's about the beautiful flower. Because the swan is so beautiful, it's not a songbird. It doesn't sing until right before it dies. It sings this beautiful, beautiful song, and then it dies, which is why we call it the swan song. So in this song, there's a beautiful flower, and the swan sees the flower and circles her, and he sings the song to her. And the narrator, which is me, says, "Oh, little flower, do you know what this means?" And you'll notice there's no resolution at the end of the song, because it's up in the air. It's the question, do you know? So it's a simple little melody, but a little bit more weight to it.
She's not really talking about flowers, but she's in a garden. She mentions flowers. And she finishes with the beautiful, beautiful phrase that I thought it was very appropriate for this night. I want to crown your face with roses.
Thank you.
event that opened the season, one of our guest tenors, we have another one sitting here, but another one of our guest tenors, Gerard Ortega, when he heard about this concert, he was like, oh, you have to do Dame de Tus Rosas. It's the sexiest song about roses I've ever heard. And I'm like, okay, I've never heard anybody describe a song about roses that way, so I need to check it out. I love the song. It's beautiful. Thank you, Gerard, for sending me the music, sending me the clip of the music. I hope I do you justice.
You heard German, Russian, Spanish, English is yet to come, and Greek. This is one of my dad's favorite songs by a beautiful composer, a Greek composer called Nikis Theodorakis. So I always dedicate it to my dad whenever I sing this song. And I want to give a credit to a wonderful conductor that I know I have worked a lot with in Greece, own Greek music, who actually made this arrangement for us today, Panagis Barbadis. My dream is to bring him here one day and have a Greek music evening. He has a beautiful orchestra. He's a wonderful conductor. He does beautiful arrangements. He has a beautiful orchestra called Mandolinata, which means, you know, full of mandolins. And the sound that they bring out, it really, you are immediately transported in Greece on an island drinking ouzo. And so my dream with Opus Opera is to bring him here one day and have a beautiful evening for you and bring a little bit of that Greek spirit. So here's a little taste tonight.
Thank you.
little lanyap.
Sure.